This is probably the most famous stamp that Nebraska ever issued. It was 1898 for the Trans-Mississippi Exposition. And it was
Edgar Hicks,
here.
Who lives in Omaha, spent most of his career as a grain commodities broker. But his passion has always been history.
It's to promote history when I go to stamp shows. Like I'm doing.
He's a collector of postcards, stamps, and letters, many from the era of African-American homesteading on the Great Plains. This portrait of the Shores family of Custer County was taken by Solomon Butcher in the late 1800s.
Every time I see that picture, it just makes you think about, you know, what did they grow? What did they eat? And what kind of cattle did they have? What contribution did that dog make to the family? What did he do?
His questions multiplied when Hicks read a newspaper article about a black settlement called Bliss in the Nebraska Sandhills. On eBay, he found a postcard mailed to Bliss, Nebraska, over a century ago. Now he's on a mission to find Bliss.
Every time I come out in these places where there's these wide open spaces, I just think, how the ham and eggs did these people get out here?
He's driving from Omaha to the little town of Plainview to meet a writer who knows more about the Bliss settlement than anyone on the planet. Dennis Vosburgh is a retired IRS agent who had never before written a novel. It all started with a chance discovery.
One of my wife's cousins lives right out in the Goose Lake area, which is right where Bliss, Nebraska was. And he came up and was just pestering me endlessly because he said his father had found an artifact out by one of the foundations of an old sod house. And this turned out to be a little toy pistol. And he was very excited about it because he asked his father where this little toy pistol, who it might have belonged to. And he said, well, that was right in the area where the black homesteaders were. And my wife's cousin said, well, how can this be? I mean, I've lived here all my life and I'm 50 years old. How can I never have heard about these black homesteaders?
After months of research, Vosburgh realized there wasn't enough information out there to write a history book. So he began a novel based on the life of a settler named Hector Dixon, a real-life homesteader in Bliss. Now Edgar Hicks is about to see it all for himself. Vosburgh's home is just 40 miles east of the place once called Bliss, on the eastern edge of the Nebraska Sandhills.
Hey, Edgar.
Yes.
Welcome to Plainview. Now, what do you think of this? Now I think this is just a miracle that those things survived.
These are portraits of Hector and Julia Dixon.
Is this Hector?
That is Hector Dixon.
The real-life couple that inspired the novel. A descendant discovered the portraits in a relative's garage just a year ago.
See that little scratch across Julia's forehead? See the little scratch up there? My central character, Hector Dixon, turned out to be one of the better educated people out there. Not only a justice of the peace in his county for something like 27 years, but he was also the school teacher in this little sod house for quite a few years. He was well educated and well respected.
But it wasn't just the portraits that were saved. In the late 19th century, the very graves of the settlers at Bliss were being threatened by erosion. White townspeople living nearby reburied them in Valley View Cemetery. In May of 2008, the descendants of white homesteaders dedicated a marker to these African-American homesteaders.
Look here, Edgar, this is so cool. Look, you see what we find down here?
It's an old orange peel.
This has been here like all winter. And these things just appear out here.
Over the past few years, someone's been leaving an orange near the marker in honor of the chapter in Hector's Bliss about a little boy who spent his last penny on a fresh orange to save his sick mother's life. It's obvious that the history means something to the people who live here now.
A Lambert and a Huffman. These people brought these burial remains up here
to be buried next to them.
We know that we had an integrated church out there. We had an integrated cemetery. We had an integrated baseball team out there. And this was before Jackie Robinson was even born.
But where was Bliss? South of Valley View Cemetery, near Goose Lake.
The old cemetery that I was telling you about is over across the lake over there by that white beach area.
Hector Dixon, his wife Julia, and other African Americans came here in the 1880s to claim their quarter section of free land.
I'm not seeing that. Bliss, how is it a community?
Well, that's a hard question to answer because it was just one little farmstead here and a farmstead there. But on Sunday, you would probably find your community gathering over there. They had a little church behind that cemetery, and that was probably the area where you'd find most people on Sundays.
Well, from the side house to the church, well, that was half a day to get to church.
well, maybe they had to ask for a lot of forgiveness. Who knows?
But the Bliss community lasted less than 30 years because it was built on a lie. Goose Lake has always been a haven for wildlife, but it's never been a good place to grow crops. In the 1880s, land agents planted chunks of coal in the ground, telling the black settlers they could make a living by mining if farming didn't work out. But as many homesteaders learned, 160 acres of Sandhills land wasn't enough to sustain a growing family. Now, even the old post office that gave Bliss, Nebraska its name is gone. Nearby is a burned-out old schoolhouse that Edgar Hicks assumed was the old post office.
I used all my film. I'm thinking that was a cotton-picking post office.
Well, I just didn't want to spoil the moment.
Well, you did. You did.
Okay. Yeah, well, I guess I owe you one. I'll try to make it up some way. But you see this piece of concrete here? All right, there's kind of an outline of a building on this concrete. Okay, this is where the little house was. It was the Bliss Post Office.
In rural Nebraska in the late 19th century, there were post offices every 2 or 3 miles, most of them in private homes.
Most of those postcards were very local. Somebody was sick, or are you going to the fair, or, I mean, they were common, you know, it was just day-to-day conversation, you know. It was the Twitters of the time. And the postal guy, if he was riding a horse, he just took it to the next house.
Piece by piece, Edgar Hicks is beginning to see the vision that was Bliss and connect it to the world we live in today. But there's one last place on the tour and one last story to tell.
This is a descendant of Hector Dixon. This is to be his great-grandson.
James Patterson is a retired minister living in California who knew nothing about his homesteading roots.
He came out here and preached, it was less than a year ago, he preached in this church right here, and then there was standing room only. They haven't had this church filled like that for years. He had almost no knowledge of his family's history.
It's taken a whole day, but Edgar Hicks has finally found Bliss.
Until you walk on the ground, you know, see the graves. See the buildings, see the cow chips, and see how they lived. And it still is different once you come out here.